Composition of microbiome in coconut little yellow in phytoplasma infected host by Mogens Nicolaisen, Nicoletta Contaldo, Wayne Neary, Marisa Luis Montoya, Camilo Paredes Tomas, Yuri Yuno, Gianni Di Bianchi, Carlos Oropesa, Carlos Freddy Ortiz, and myself. I think I mentioned everybody. If I forgot somebody, we will add in the abstract, but I think these are the institutions involved in the coconut palm part. We can continue. So just for those, I think the audience was different the 3 days. So a little explanation, we already saw this. What was the aim of this part of the research was exploring by using next generation sequencing the phytoplasma genetic diversity in single host plant or insect and exploring possibly phytoplasma interaction with the microbiome. The difficulty that was partly overcome was that the system decided to be used was focused on the bacteria. And in several cases, it is complicated because organelle DNA are also amplified by the primer used for this. So Mogens, who did the work, was the work of the sequencing, was obliged to degenerate the primer already available in literature for bacteria in order to, after alignment, appropriately degenerate the primer in order to have bacteria and phytoplasma and Candidatus liberibacter amplified from the sample. These are the coconut sample. You see, we have at least two batches in the time, a first batch in 2019 and another in last summer, 2021, and also from all the partners I mentioned. And there are also some insect batches, both from Cuba and Mexico is down, but is there. Continue with the next one. This is the system used. It's just is an amplification with the low melting temperature. So you get this polyband, but the expected, the wanted band is, I think, about 500 base pair. It was cut from the gel and sent for sequencing. This work was done hundreds of times because the sample were many. And these are the same slide you see the other night in which I pointed out coconut palm. You see the blue phytoplasma are marked on the top. And beside phytoplasma, I checked because it's very difficult to read this slide. The major, the pink, light pink was Pantoea. It was a lot. This is a general result about the coconut palm. Let's go to the next one. This is another evaluation that was done dividing the sample by different location. The one in which I wrote phytoplasma is just to show you the color in which you can recognize the phytoplasma in the different column. But this was a sample Mogens received from, I think, a major Arizona through Methodist. So it was very, very infected. The other were our normal, let's say, sample. The first column, I think it is the one from, I cannot read, Africa, is Ghana, I think, and after is America. You see, in both cases, you have phytoplasma, but it's not the same length of band. This is a very rough amplification. So it goes by very copy number. So if the copy number is very low, you either don't see the band of phytoplasma in some cases. It doesn't mean the phytoplasma are not there because all the sample we provided for this work were tested in Bologna laboratory and verified for the phytoplasma presence. So after we send everything negative and positive, but in every country, let's say, except for Grape Wine on Sunday, we get some positive for phytoplasma. So the system not always detected the phytoplasma presence. You can see where I put the red arrow is Ghana, the three area Andidi explained you, the central, western, and other area, and you see that the phytoplasm is, I try to mark, you have a huge amount in one area, a little bit less in the first on the left, and almost nothing, I put a dot in the center. So the amount of detectable phytoplasma is different. It was presented also the phytoplasma can be differentiated. This is another angle. Don't think that the quantity of phytoplasma is directly related to the symptomatology. It doesn't work like this. Even if it looks like the phytoplasma load can fill the cube, can fill the vascular bundles, but the interaction is more complex. It's not only a physical interaction. There are hormonal interactions that can excite or change the symptomatology. And the last, I think, are the insects. I cannot read exactly from here. I am very blind. The last two, no. I think one is again Africa, and it is the sample from Equatorial Guinea, the second Africa. And the last one,
Jamaica.
You see Jamaica. It's just a little spot on the top, but doesn't matter. They were all positive, the sample. So this is the amount. Let's go to the next one. This is insect. I was telling Erica, I will explain tonight. There are the two not colored are the Diaphorina citri. Morgan's put together all the sample. He didn't follow the vector and so on. But all the other are related to the palm story. In general, what you see on the right are all from Tabasco. You have almost no phytoplasma. We detected phytoplasma in those samples. But if Carlos Fred is listening, we didn't detect a little yellow phytoplasma. We detect other phytoplasmas. In any case, in the insect, I think there is only a plexus. The blue one is the same color in which we find phytoplasmas. There are other prevalent, but I have a more detailed picture. If we go quickly here, you see that the number of infected sample, you know, the copy number is not very high in several cases. Go to the next one. This is also showing you, was made expressly by Morgens. He was able in this case, you remember you asked him about OTU. For this little yellowing, he did the OTUs, and you can see OTU number 3 is Candidatus phytoplasma palmicola, and the other is Candidatus phytoplasma palme. So he was able to recognize at least the two main phytoplasma. But as he said and Nicoletta said, we are still working on this data. Let's go to the next one. This is the data diversity. The different country, you see Africa, America, Jamaica, and so on. There is some clustering, but not very geographically oriented. I think Jamaica is the black, so it's in the middle of the other Africa and America. So the beta diversity is not exactly compartmentalized by country. Here is more difficult. I put because he was giving me, you see the relationship is the same he showed you last night. The red lane are the negative association. So following the red lane and reading which bacterium is there, this could be possible candidate for control because it is negatively correlated by computer. But I think we need to look very deep in these cases before draw conclusion. These are just splitted by country. The data referred to the 2019, but in this case, one of our students, together with Nicoletta, elaborated this data for the her thesis. So we can see easily, this is the Ghana, but I mean, it's only 1 year. The Ghana, the Acoleplasmatace are the phytoplasma group, but you see there is a very huge amount of one Enterobacteria, yes. This is the main genus we found in Ghana. And they also look at the otus, and of course it was Candidatus phytoplasma parnicola. Let's go. Here we have, it is Jamaica. Again, this is Candidatus phytoplasma parme. You see the Aquileplasmatace. Again, Enterobacteriaceae is a huge amount, but you have other families. There is more variability, in a sense, in these Jamaican samples. Let's go to the next. This is Mexico. Mexico 2019 is only Carlos, I think, Oropesa, not the Tabasco. We do not have those here. There was a huge amount, but a few samples of Aquileplasmatace. Again, there was the Enterobacteriaceae, but a little bit more other bacterial genus having some prevalence. And this, again, Candidatus phytoplasma parme. So they ought to were fitting with the data. The Cuba sample, the Cuba sample are a little bit astonishing. We have a lot of Aquileplasmatace and a lot of Enterobacteriaceae and some other diversity scattered, not very represented, but very biodiverse. Again, it was Candidatus phytoplasma parme. After this is elaboration about the otus and the percentage of identity to the type strain, to the Candidatus phytoplasma officially published. And so you see that there is some variation. There is not always 100%. I will not go into the type. In one case, you already see I marked, this is Africa, and it was found also palme. We don't know if it is a contamination. These are the data. Maybe it's a, but just in one case, we have Cocos Tanzania that has a sequence more similar, but the otus validity for classification is questionable. Let's go to the next one. Jamaica, Cuba, Mexico, everything was fitting. And in every place, we found some difference from the strain, the type strain. You see the identity percentage. They range, but this is a little piece. So we cannot use this percentage of identity for classification. It's just a rough idea of the biodiversity inside the phytoplasma. Let's go to the next one. Just to give you this example, 12 sequence out of 69 resulted 100% identical to those in gene bank in one case. And this girl was writing, but I did intentionally, I left. The identity was lower than 97.5%. I take these last few minutes of your patience just to tell you this was the threshold we are historically using to make a new Candidatus. The paper I mentioned, and somebody already asked that they cannot find in the web. I don't know how long it takes to publish the International Journal of Systematics. Is also is publishing two new Candidatus for Palme. And also changing the threshold to make a new Candidatus. We decided as a group, the taxonomy group joined from phytoplasmology and mycoplasmology, we were 12 people. We decided, no, 14 probably, I can't remember, a group. We decided to raise the threshold to 98.65%. That is also the threshold for the bacteria in general. And it is in some way helping some situation. Unfortunately, it's not helping all the situation, but this will be in force as soon as the paper is published. And so people can work and have maybe there are putative possible new Candidatus in order to better clarify and help in the management. Because if we don't know exactly what is, we can go like showed by both Wayne and Fabienne to the this they call haplotype. I don't know if this is fitting with something, but this internal biodiversity in more gene. But in reality, we need to know, are they the beast we are looking for or is another beast? After you can play on strain, and we all learned that the strain is the one making the epidemic. I was teaching for 20 years, now we know on our skin. But to know if it is a strain or not, we need a rule. This is what we try to do for all the community. Okay, here there is this is the biodiversity. So the number of different microorganism genus found in the different sample. There is, you see better in the, continue, better in the other slide. I think I will stay for some question if any, but I really like to close this 3 days marathon with thanking all the Tropic Safe Consortium for providing the sample of palm and of grape wine and of citrus. And in particular, we thank for the work of the invisible people that are in Mogens Laboratory, Matilde Shiradej and Enoch Kudjorge, and in my laboratory, Giulia Feduzzi and Francesco Pacini, because they handled the huge amount of sample. And I think Enoch is the one now using the computer to try to get the information, the useful information out of this bench that is, I don't know if it is comparable with the work of genetic in the whole genome, but it is a tough bioinformatic work to be done. And I think with this, I finish my presentation. If you have questions, I am here. I try to be clear, but you know, the microbiome is a fascinating topic, but it is also difficult to correctly evaluate. I think microbiome and genome are both complex. If you have questions.